This animation is a simplified model of plant-soil-water interaction. In this model, we have the plant growing in the soil matrix. And as you can see, the soil has many random pores. Before we begin, it is worth noting that this setup is an artificial one. If the soil was as dry as it is in the beginning here, the plant would be quite dead. However, we have to start somewhere, and so present our model system in this artificial state. Next, look at the pores. There are three types. These pores are defined based on their size and their ability to hold onto water with different force. The macropores, large pores that are commonly found between aggregates and frequently interconnected, in most situations are air-filled and don't hold onto water with any force worth mentioning. Micropores, the very small pores found inside aggregates, hold water so tightly that plants can't access it. Mezzo pores, pores of intermediate size between macro and micropores, hold water with enough tension that it doesn't flow out of the system due to gravity, but is also still accessible to the plant roots. It is important to remember these pore size classes are not arbitrarily assigned. Okay, let's start our story. A large storm has rolled through this area. Lots of rain has fallen, and many liters of water have completely filled the pore space in this soil. At this point, the soil is at the saturated moisture state. Immediately after the rain stops, the macropores, recall that they don't really hold water, start to drain. After about 2 hours, all of the macropores will have drained, which is not really enough time for the plant roots to access the water. Again, all that large pore space is not helpful for supplying the plant with water. At this point, the soil is at the field capacity moisture state. All of the gravity-drained water has left the system via the macropores, leaving the water held by the mesopores and micropores. Next, the sun comes up and starts shining on our model system. Let's look at the above-ground part of the plant. First, we'll zoom in on the openings of the leaf surfaces, called stomata. The plant can actively open and close these. As soon as the sun rises and there's energy for photosynthesis, the plant will want carbon dioxide so that it can synthesize the CO2 into carbohydrates. Conveniently, the Earth's atmosphere has abundant CO2. So, to allow the CO2 into the interior of the plant, the stomata need to be opened. Once the stomata are opened, the moisture that is inside the plant begins to escape. It evaporates into the atmosphere. The evaporation of the water from the stomata creates a pressure gradient, also known as a difference in water potential, wherein there is lower potential outside the plant. Due to the cohesion of water molecules, that is, the attraction of water molecules to each other, and the tendency of water to flow from areas of higher potential to areas of lower potential, water is drawn up vertically through the plant. This process, the movement of water through the plant and its eventual evaporation, is called transpiration. And in fact, we can trace the flow of water from the evaporation at the stomata all the way down the plant, through the stem, through the roots, to the water-filled soil pores that the roots are near to or in contact with. Looking at the root system, we can see the threads of water flowing from the mesopores into the roots. While we know that the plant needs a lot of water, we also know that the plant needs nutrients. The water in the soil is not just a commodity by itself. It is also the carrier of and means to transport nutrients. In our example, we have a nutrient cation, calcium, and a water molecule moving towards the root, pulled along in the water, and then flowing upward through the root system and into the above-ground plant. The water molecule flows all the way up to the leaf surface and is evaporated into the atmosphere, while the calcium ion is deposited in the plant tissue. Although this is a simplified model, the mass flow of nutrient cations dissolved in soil water is essential for plant nutrition. Advancing time in our model, the plant available water in the mesopores is eventually all transpired by the plant, leaving only the so-called dead water in the micropores, which is held too tightly by capillary force for the plant to extract it. This soil moisture state is called permanent wilting point. And indeed, if this situation, no plant available water, goes on for a while, the plant will eventually wilt, and if allowed to continue, will die.